Good morning, buenos dias to all my friends out there. Today, I have a story for you. This story will be in English. This story comes from a book called Shenanigans at South. I wrote it with my third graders a couple years ago at South. I hope you like it. This story is chapter one. It's called, How Rude! Here's the picture. Gia had seen a movie last night. It had been a wonderful movie. Gia liked it because the girl spy and the boy spy went out and got French fries at the end. Gia's dad liked it because of the shooting and car chases. Gia's mom liked it because it had been such a long day and Gia's favorite part was when the girl spy was fighting the bad guys. Put down your guns, the girl spy said. The bad guys laughed at her. The girl spy yelled, How rude! And she stomped on the bad leader's foot. He yelled and fell over and the girl spy won. Gia thought the girl spy was a great role model. When Gia's dad brought her to parent jump off the next day, he had a little limp. Good luck, said Gia's dad. He left. Gia ran over to Madison. Good morning, Madison, she said, and threw her arms out for a hug. Hang on, said Madison. She was writing in her journal. How rude, yelled Gia. She looked for Madison's feet. They were under the table where Madison was sitting. She said. Gia skipped over to the coat cubbies. Victoria was taking out her pink puffy coat. Josh was sitting in the closet, fiddling with his backpack. I need to put my things down, called Gia. Give me a sec, said Josh. My backpack zipper's stuck. How rude, Gia yelled. She pulled her foot up, but Josh was sitting cross-legged. She couldn't get his foot. She snorted. Gia started to walk over to her desk. Colin bumped into her. He was walking backwards, trying to keep a red feather in the air, like this. How rude, yelled Gia. She stomped after Colin and caught up to him by the windows. She raised her foot up and threw it down, but Colin saw it coming. He moved his foot back. Hey, yelled Gia. What? Laughed Colin. What are you doing? Gia pulled her foot up and thrust it down again. Colin stepped away again. Colin laughed. You can't get me, and ran to the other end of the room. Gia started to run after him, but then she saw, a teacher's name. I'm going to change it to a skip-back teacher's name. She saw Mrs. Chuba standing near her desk, talking to Anya and Cammie. Mrs. Chuba, Gia called. I need help. Mrs. Chuba turned to her. What is it, Gia? Everyone is being really rude to me today, she said. I just wanted to show them what I saw in a movie last night. Oh, said Mrs. Chuba. Well, why don't you show me? Okay, said Gia. You have to say something mean first. Okay, Mrs. Chuba looked around. Your shoe's untied. Gia smiled. How rude, she yelled. She brought her foot up, threw it down, and... Mrs. Chuba, look at the puppy I drew last night, shouted Cammie. Mrs. Chuba turned and looked. Gia missed. Mrs. Chuba! Gia screamed. You have to stay still! Okay, said Mrs. Chuba. I am totally focused this time. She widened her eyes at Gia. That's my puppy, said Anya. Mrs. Chuba! Just a second, Anya, said Mrs. Chuba. I drew it for Mrs. Fox, Anya yelled. Okay, said Gia. How rude! She jumped off the floor and slammed her feet down. It's mine! Anya was shaking Mrs. Chuba's shoulder. Mrs. Chuba turned to Anya. Gia hit the ground again. Mrs. Chuba! She screamed. It's okay, Anya, said Mrs. Chuba. It's a very nice puppy, no matter who made it. Gia suddenly decided she liked what the boy spy did in the movie better. She tapped Mrs. Chuba on the shoulder. Mrs. Chuba turned. Gia punched her in the face. That's the end of chapter one. How rude! Here's another picture from chapter one. I think Gia's standing there just wondering, who can she stomp her foot on? I hope you liked my story. If it was a funny story, I hope you laughed. If you have an idea for a story that I should write and tell on YouTube, then leave me something in the comments. Leave me your idea. I would love to hear from you. I hope you have an awesome day. Do lots of good things and keep practicing and keep learning. Remember, you can make it a great day or not. The choice is yours. Adios.